I am Anurudh Thiname. Welcome to our Facebook page and board YouTube channel Born Insight. Today I solve a new problem which has come from JEE Mains 2019. The question is 72, 19 January morning evening shift. And we now discuss another two problem which is from statistics and another problem from sequence. So first we start this problem. Let A, B, C be the 7th, 11th and 13th term respectively of a non-constant AP. 7th, 11th and 13th term respectively of a non-constant AP. That means arithmetic progression. So we write this term, that means A equal to capital A plus 7 minus 1 D, while A is the initial term of the arithmetic progression and D is the common difference. Again B equal to A plus 11 minus 1 into D, and C equal to A plus 13 minus 1 into D. So we get this equal to A plus 6 D, B equal to A plus 10 D, C equal to A plus 12 D. Again we see that if these are also the three consecutive term of a GP, that means geometric progression of this term ABC in a sequential process, then find the value of A by C. So since ABC are in GP, so if now B by A equal to C by B, that means B square equal to AC. Where is B? B is this. So A plus 10D square, A equal to capital A plus 6D, and C equal to capital A plus 12D. We now calculate. So get A square plus 20 AD plus 100 D square. Similarly, right hand side A to A square plus 72 D square plus 12 16 6 so plus 18. This A square and A square cancel out from the side, and now we get this equal to 20 AD minus 18 AD, that means 100 minus 72, that means 28. So A by AD equal to 14D square. 14D. This is not a capital D, this is this one. So DD out, we get
by d equal to 14. A by d equal to 14. I will check this and this. Next we calculate a by c. What I say, a is the term a plus c, and c is the term a plus 12 t. That means a by d plus 6, a by d plus 12, which is a by d equal to minus 14 plus 6, minus 14 plus 12. So that means minus 8 minus 2. So this minus minus out and 4, so we get 4. So we have the value a by c equal to 4. So 2 is the right answer. And the next problem, this is the question number 75. The question is, a data consists of n observation x1, x2, x3, dot dot xn. If summation over I equal to 1 to n xi plus 1 to the power square equal to 9n, and summation over I equal to 1 to n xi minus 1 to the power square equal to 5n, then find the standard deviation of this data. So first we write this summation xi plus 1 square, 1 equal to I equal to 1 to n equal to 9. This equal to, we write summation xi square plus 2 into summation xi plus 10. So okay, equal to 9. This is number. Okay, summation I equal to 1 to n xi minus 1 equal to 5. That means summation over xi minus 2 summation xi I equal to 1 to n plus 5 equal to 5. This is number 2. Now adding 1 and 2, we get this and this out. So 2 into summation xi square plus 2n equal to 14n. That means summation xi square equal to 14n minus 12, that is 12 by 2, that is 6n. So we get summation xi by n equal to 6. This is number 3. Again, again subtract 1 from 2. If we subtract this and this out, so 4 summation xi, this and out, and we get 9 minus 5 n, 9 n minus 5 n equal to 4 n. So we get summation xi by n equal to 1. This is number 4. We know the variance. We know the variance of the above data, that means sigma square, which is called variance, is equal to summation xi square by n minus summation xi by n to the power square equal to, this value equal to 6 and this value equal to 1 square, that means 5. So we find SD equal to sigma, that means root over five. So root 5 is the correct answer. So the error data is standard deviation is root 5. The next problem, this is the question number 86, and this question from geometry. The line x is equal to ay plus b, comma z equal to cy plus d, and x is equal to a dash z plus b dash, comma y equal to c dash z plus d dash are perpendicular, then which of the condition is true? So this line can be written in symmetrical form. So we have x is equal to ay plus b, that means x minus b by a equal to y, z equal to cy plus b, that means z minus d equal to by c equal to y. So combining this we get x minus b by a, y minus 0 by 1, z minus d by c. This is the equation of the straight line which passes through the point B, 0, D, and whose CS are A, 1, C. So we can say that this is M1, this is L1, this is M1, this is L1. Again, the given straight line is X is equal to A dash Z plus B dash, y equal to c dash z plus d dash, which can be written x minus b dash by a dash equal to z y minus d dash by c dash equal to z. That means x minus b dash by a dash, y minus b dash by c dash, z minus 0 by 1. So this is the another straight line. This line passes through the point b dash d dash 0, and whose DCS are this a dash c dash 1, which is called L2, this is called M2, this is called N2. We know if the two lines, suppose this is the line 1, this is the line 2, and this line and this line, this is 1, this is 2. If these two lines are perpendicular, so this angle will be 90 degree, and we can say that their DCS, this line DCS, A, 1, C. A1C, which is the DCS of this line, and this is A dash C dash 1. This is the DCS of the line. So this angle is theta. So you can say that L1, L2, M1, M2 plus N1, N2 equal to 0, because theta is 90 degrees. So multiply A into A dash 1 into C dash, that is C dash, C into 1, that is C. So now compare A into A dash plus C plus C dash. So 2 is the right answer. So guys, if you like my video, please share, comment and inform your friend, and go to our YouTube channel Born in Soil, where more videos I have uploaded. Thank you very much. Thank you.